If there are any background noises, I apologise in advance. But I have got a really good book to recommend for all of you. And it's from Michael Morpurgo. It's called Kensuke's Kingdom. There were all sorts of books that Michael Morpurgo writ, but Kensuke's Kingdom is one of my favourites because it's got all sorts of interesting plots and twists. You can always ask yourself any questions, and it's also a really popular book in my school. You can obviously read this book anytime you want, but I will. Now, this is a spoiler, so you can skip to like a few, like about 10 seconds on from now. Michael is a very popular character and he will survive everything he goes through. I think the spoiler has been completed in like a few seconds, so I would say I can carry you on. So, Kensuke's Kingdom is a book where you can really feel emotion, and I'll read this blurb to you. It's Kensuke's Kingdom. I heard the wind above me in the sail. I remember thinking, this is silly, you haven't got your safety harness on. You haven't got your life jacket on. You shouldn't be doing this. I was cold in the sea before I could even open my mouth to scream. Washed up on an island in the Pacific Ocean, Michael struggles to survive on his own with no food and no water. He curls up to die. When he wakes, there is a plate beside him of fish, of fruit, and a bowl of fresh water. He is not alone. Another spoiler. If you don't want to hear the spoiler, reach out for like 10 seconds from now. He is not alone because Kensuke is with him. That's why it's called Kensuke's Kingdom. And then I think the spoiler's done. Sorry for all the mess on my hands. I've been writing a little book. It's for all the ideas, and I just came across making like a book review. There's also a little bit of Japanese. I'm so sorry. Japanese. Some of the characters will say, well, only one of the characters will be talking in Japanese here. So, another little thing. Skip 10 seconds if you don't want this spoiler. Kikumbo, Kimi, and Michia, are all characters. If I went a little too far with, like, the 10 seconds, then I apologise. But all of these are all, like, I don't know, Japanese words that you will spot in the book somewhere. I've definitely spotted this, like, I've spotted most of these in the book. Now you can, there's also, like, Japanese writing, on the side. It is a very nice book. I will be reading this to some of you. Follow it. Well, not for us, YouTubers, if you are a YouTuber and you want to, like, get a little hold of this book so you can make, videos about it. And for all you normal viewers, I'll be reading this for you as well, eventually, because I've already read it with my class, my literacy class, and it's really, really fun. I've got the newer copy. And there are quite a few chapters, a little drama, if I would say so myself. Trying to look for the bit where it shows you the chapters. Now, Peggy Sue is the boat. It's not too much. Water everywhere. You can obviously think what it is in the blurb. The ship's log. Every ship has a log where you write things down. Gibbons and ghosts. You can go search out what a gibbon is. It's like a type of monkey if you don't want it. And then Kensuke is, well, yeah, he's on, I'll say he, that's all I'm gonna say. And then a bunny. We did check what that means somewhere. Just flip this back so I can actually go back to it later. A bunny, where is that? That means danger. A little bit of a cliffhanger at her, and then all that silence said. Can't remember reading that, but I did read the whole book. I can't remember what it happened there. Everyone died in Nagasaki. That is a place. Night of the Turtles. Special little cute little thing. Come and come. Postscript. Glossary. Map of the route. I'll show you the map. I still read. But I'm not going to be telling you too much because I'll be reading this to you all. So here is where he first landed. So about here. And then that is the cave he spent his first night. So only his first night. Which was like here. These up here. These mean tracks are like he went practically like all over here. Right, and then he went all the way around. And then that's where Kensuke kept Outrigger. And Outrigger was like somewhere here. He hid it because he didn't really trust Michael, that's all I'm gonna say. Outrigger's a boat. Sorry I'm saying so many spoilers without warning you. But yet again, Kensuke's Kingdom is an amazing book. I recommend you reading it. And yes, Warhorse is from Michael Morpurgo. There are all sorts of books in his, well, series. Most of them are about animals. I've got to, oh, sorry about the noises as well. Yes, he is a master storyteller. If you read this book, you will understand, and you will definitely agree, because of this amazing book. It's not too long, I would say. Now, it might seem like it's a really long book, but if you enjoy it, then it'll seem like it's so short you want to read on. And there's just a little bit of a cliffhanger at the end somewhere. The postscript really left me thinking. I really... Excuse. I'm not going to let you read it all, so... Unless you paused it, you're really smart. And, yeah. So, just going to say, book recommendation, Michael Morpurgo is a great author. Kensuke's Kingdom, great book. I'll be reading it to you someday, sometime. Sorry for the late posting, though. I've got so many plans to make. But I will say, you should read this book. Read any book by Michael Morpurgo. I'm sure you will love it. So, goodbye. Yeah, my hands are really weird. Bye. You're my angels, by the way. So, bye. Also, read Kensuke's Kingdom. That's the whole point. I made like 8 minutes of making this video. I used 8 minutes of my time. So...